And here we go.
I said, like, you know, he's got to get a credit card, he's got to call the bank, he's got to take care of that. And she goes, well, if we don't, we're going to have to send you to a public hospital.
Oh, God.
Eight beds per room.
Oh, God.
No air conditioning, plus all the family members.
Oh, my God.
He got up and came back, and I was on morphine for a week. And then I had a...
Hobby, Texas.
I said, what's going on?
I've got it, and I'm like, no, I have Blue Cross Blue Shield, but I got it.
I said, this is nuts.
Let's see, let me tell you something. Walking through the city, he didn't pay, I didn't pay one penny out of pocket when he had a stroke.
You sure?
They covered everything, and then he was in a rehab facility for a month. They paid for that.
Sure.
What would I do if he didn't work for the city and have this covered? Where did I get the money?
Getting ready for takeoff.
They keep changing your medical coverage without telling you.
Yeah.
And a lot of doctors don't take it. A lot of doctors don't take a United Blue Cross Blue Shield.
I know.
When I was in California, I had no problems. I had Blue Cross Blue Shield forever. No problem. I come up to Texas and I'm finding the doctor. And then the doctors, I come. Just a pain. And then so I changed to Texas Plus. And mine were worse. Because I covered nothing outside of Texas.
Of course.
Just like, I said, like, you know what? I'm going to go outside of Texas for vacations.
I know.
So I changed to Aetna. And that's the same damn way. They pay for this and they don't pay for that. And it's like, if they don't put the right coding in when they send it in, they won't pay for it. It's like,
I know. It's ridiculously crazy. Sal, don't point that at me.
It's
at
me.
It's crazy. I know.
It was
well,
totally
it's funny. My son's out there, and he got a job doing scaffolding. It's 100 degrees there. And every time he turned around, he was in the hospital. He was dehydrated.
Right.
No matter how much he drank, he sweat it out.
Right.
He did that for a year. Finally, he turned around and went to his boss, and he said, well, you have to get me something inside. My body cannot handle the heat out here. I can't be, they found him on the floor.
Right.
This is the, I can't keep dehydrated like this. He says, I don't have anything inside my son's liver. So quick. So now he works in a car place doing oil changes and whatever.
Okay.
He's inside.
Right.
Air conditioning. But he's a carpenter also by trade. So he could really do anything.
Right.
But he had to turn around quick. Where he was working, he's working outside. 102 degrees. Can't do this no more. I said to him, he called me up. I'm at work. Okay, where are you? I'm in the emergency room. Every week he was in the emergency room. Damn, one time they found him on the floor.
Number one for departure, cabin crew, please proceed.
All of a sudden they found him on the floor. He went into the emergency room. The doctor went crazy because his pressure was through the roof. His white count had dropped. He wound up with some kind of urinary tract infection. That's when he turned around and told his boss, I have to leave. You can't get me a job in sight. I have to go.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what he did. Every time I talk to him, he's in the emergency room. And they said,
take care of
no matter
yourself.
How much you drink,
just go
sweating.
District. She worked for the school district. He's a natural electrician. all the breeze.
And it's blowing 80 miles an hour, and you can't even see across the road. He said, like, you know what? The kids love the summer. And he said, well, we've got 4 months. And the rest of the time, they're inside. Well, especially his daughter, because she doesn't ski. Well, him and the kid go skiing, but they can't go all the time.
Yeah.
And so he said, like, they're sitting around playing games, and they're, you know, watching TV. And he goes, I need more for my kids. So he put his house is on for sale now. And he got a job already. So he's in Austin right now. And he said, damn, it's so different here. He's having to live with his mother-in-law, because she lives there. And, but the job is like 40 miles away. He said, I'm spending 40 bucks a day on tolls and gas. They got him a truck. And then the truck, the alternator went out on it.
Oh,
and he goes,
God.
So he said, I've been spending 40 bucks a day to go to work since. He said, it's supposed to be ready on Monday, but they haven't sold the house, so they can't buy a house here.
Oh, God.
And the one, they need the kids to get in school.
We're still on the runway, for God's sake.
So I don't know what the hell they're going to do.
Oh, yeah.
And he goes, I called my boss and said, like, is my job still open? He goes, yeah, you want to come back? Come back. And then he called him back and said, you know what? Because you get your notice and you have to wait a year to come back. Well, it was with a school district, so she loved her job as a school district.
Oh,
she loved it. She helped the teacher. She loved it.
My son, husband said, my son said this. He said, if something happens to him, I'm bringing him to you. You said, you have nobody there.
Right.
So, this way, you come and, you know, you're with me.
Right.
He's with us, you know, and that's it.
That's why I'm in Texas, but my husband died. One was in Wyoming,
my son doesn't
Texas.
Want to stay.
And
you want to know the truth? I don't want to stay. I'd rather be there.
Yeah.
Because I'm going to retire from the job. I'm a nurse's aide. For 35 years. I have 3 years to retire.
Right.
I'm going to pack it in because I can't. That's it. That's the kind of work I do. I used to have to live for the electronic machines to do it.
Hello.
Well, like I said, I haven't seen my son in 6 years. I haven't been there in 6 years.
Right. I assure you, I'm gonna see if I could hold the phone and do
I'm
this
surpri-
at the same time.
I'm surprised you're.
Give it time, you'll know. I'm doing this to show somebody.
2 minutes, he'll start sweating.
I gotta hold the phone.
You have to see him in the car. All of a sudden, he's sweating like a pig. What's the matter? Stop and go. Traffic.
Hello.
It's awesome.
I gotta see if I can hold the phone. Play handball in the sky, people. If you can, I'd win.
Yeah, it's crazy.
Everyone in their seatbelts, please.
I have easy pass, so, and I have a discount card.
going to go in the water.
Yeah, that's where we are, water.